At the heart of the Canon EOS R mirrorless system is optics. Since shortly after World War II, Canon has been an important world player in optical development for interchangeable lens cameras, and it's important to understand that this, not simply a more compact camera, is the driving force behind the new EOS R system. The EOS R series takes this to new levels and opens the door to incredible lens and image quality possibilities in the future. But the great news is that it remains fully compatible with current Canon EF, EFS, tilt shift, and macro lenses. Any discussion of the Canon EOS R series has to begin with the RF lens mount. This is a new lens mount dedicated to the EOS R full-frame mirrorless system. From the outset, let's be clear. Only RF mount lenses can be directly attached to the new mirrorless cameras. All existing compatible Canon lenses for digital SLRs will require an optional mount adapter. In a few moments, we'll discuss why this new lens mount and its architecture are such an important part of the EOS R system. But first, let's talk about the four RF mount lenses that will debut with the EOS R camera system. These are entirely new designs, leveraging the advantages of the camera's mirrorless structure. Each has much more extensive and faster data communication with the camera, and each has the new programmable RF series control ring, in addition to a manual focus ring and zoom ring on the zoom lenses. Let's take a quick look at each lens. The RF 24-105mm F4 L IS USM. The 24-105mm F4 L IS USM lens is the first standard zoom in the RF lens system. As with each of the RF lenses, it's a totally new lens design, optimized for the new mirrorless system. It's slightly smaller than its EF mount sibling, and its image quality will be improved. The F4 maximum aperture is constant through the zoom range. Most notably, this is the first L-series lens with Canon's innovative nano ultrasonic focus motor. Nano USM means this lens's focus is fast, virtually silent, but in particular, it has focus smoothness ideally suited for video recording. This is not simply a kit lens, and we expect it to be a workhorse for many of our serious customers who invest in the EOS R system. The RF 28-70mm F2 L USM. Here is the flagship lens in the first wave of optics for the EOS R system. You heard that correctly. This is Canon's first constant aperture F2 zoom lens. The priority here was superb specifications with that F2 maximum aperture and the best image quality possible. Listen to this carefully. The result is a lens so good, we expect some to consider it a variable fixed focal length lens, not just a wide to tele zoom. Canon's lens engineers anticipate this lens will offer unprecedented optical quality, matching the sharpness and contrast of many pro-level fixed focal length lenses. While it's certainly large for a lens of its type, understand that the RF mount architecture makes it possible. Had our engineers tried to design a comparable F2 zoom lens for DSLRs with the EF mount, the result would have been a far larger and heavier lens. As we'll explain in a moment, the wide diameter RF mount and mirrorless structure allow designers to use larger lens elements toward the rear of the lens and reduce the size of optics toward the front section. It goes without saying that this lens will be a fixture with quality-conscious Canon photographers in fields ranging from landscape to commercial studio photography. Anywhere a superb quality 28mm, 35mm, 50mm, or 70mm lens with an F2 aperture would fit, we expect to see critical users working with the RF 28-70mm F2L lens. The RF 35mm F1.8 MACRO IS STM. Small, lightweight lenses are one of the design paths our engineers can take with the new wide-diameter mirrorless RF lens system. And the 35mm moderate wide-angle lens has historically been a go-to focal length to combine with a more compact camera for candid street shooting, available light work indoors, and even photojournalism. The 35mm f1.8 macro ISSTM fits this description well and goes beyond by offering macro close focusing capability down to half life-size magnification. At its closest focus distance of just over 6 inches, you can fill the frame with a subject the size of a business card. The wide f1.8 maximum aperture makes it great for available light shooting, and that's backed up by an image stabilization system with up to 5 stops of shake correction. Let's put that into perspective. For still image shooting in low light, if the slowest, safe shutter speed you felt comfortable using without IS was 1/60th of a second, a 5-stop correction means you'd get the same stable images at speeds as slow as 1/2 second with stationary subjects. That same IS system works beautifully for video recording as well, and the STM focus system means that AF during video is smooth and virtually silent. The RF 50mm f1.2 L USM. This lens shows another direction that the new mirrorless RF mount allows our optical designers to take. Instead of going for the smallest possible design, the RF 50mm f1.2 L USM combines an extremely wide maximum aperture with rock-solid image quality and directly targets professional photographers and critical enthusiasts. Once again, this is a totally new optical design with 15 lens elements, taking full advantage of the new possibilities of the RF lens mount and putting optical performance superior to the current EF 50mm f1.2 lens in the photographer's hands. This new 50mm lens is a powerful statement of the image quality you can get with the Canon EOS R system. With its combination of terrific low-light shooting capability, beautiful background blurring, and sharpness, we expect it to be well-received by photographers in fields such as portrait, fashion, events, and weddings. No discussion of the optical power of the Canon EOS R system is complete without a look at why this new lens mount is such an important element in raising the performance bar. The keys are that the new RF mount has a wide diameter, the same 54mm inner diameter as the EF mount, and that it's positioned much closer to the imaging sensor. The rear reference point on the lens mount is now 20mm from the image sensor plane, which is less than half the distance from the mount to sensor in an EOS digital SLR. With large diameter rear lens elements closer to the image sensor, the optics at the front of lenses can be smaller in size without loss of image quality. Light rays, especially at the outer edges of the image, can travel a smoother path through the lens with less bending or refracting. Optical designers have more freedom to engineer lenses with outstanding maximum apertures, like the RF 28-70mm f2 L USM, while maintaining superb image quality. Or deliver lenses with smaller front optical designs and reduced overall size, like the RF 35mm f1.8 ISSTM. Wide-angle lenses in particular can be designed to deliver superior performance with smaller designs than would be possible with SLR construction. This in turn can directly result in shorter lens designs with equivalent image quality and reduced lens size and weight toward the front section of the lens. And most importantly, it opens the door for superior optical quality across the entire full frame sensor area out to the corners. With large diameter rear elements, light at the edges doesn't need to be bent or refracted as strongly as it leaves the lens, enhancing final digital image quality. As we said a moment ago, some lens designs can be shorter overall. This is especially important with wide-angle lens designs and gives our engineers tremendous freedom to develop future lenses with outstanding sharpness and quality. Again, optics are the cornerstone of the new EOS R system. The first 4 lenses are just the tip of the iceberg. Finally, with the new EOS R system, we enter a new realm of data communication between body and lens as well. There are now 12 electronic contacts on the rear of RF lenses, up from 8 on EF and EFS lenses. And electronic data itself travels much faster than with the previous mount system. This means that current technologies like autofocus and image stabilization can be enhanced and offer better speed and precision. And it opens the door for new features, like fine exposure control with the new control ring on RF lenses, 1/8 stop aperture control during video shooting, moving the distance scale from the lens to the viewfinder, storing sophisticated digital lens optimizer data in each RF lens, and more possibilities in the future. As important as these new developments are for the EOS R system today, we realize that for many prospective users, their investment in Canon EF and EFS lenses has been a backbone of their involvement in photography. The EOS R system is an addition to the Canon line, not a replacement. In our next video, we'll discuss the outstanding compatibility the EOS R system provides, allowing you to use today's lenses on tomorrow's camera.